Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Now, today's tip comes from Suzanne in Chicago. I met Suzanne at one of my Power Excel seminars. Now, we already have a bunch of seminars scheduled for the fall. Now, of course, the big one is the Data Analyst Boot Camp in Chicago. That's September 18th through the 20th. It's 3 days, Excel and Access, hosted by myself and Mike Alexander. If you're interested in an Excel and Access, great opportunity. We also have a number of half-day seminars. Already we're scheduled for Birmingham, Alabama, Milwaukee, Wisconsin, Madison, Wisconsin, Springfield, Illinois, Springfield, Missouri. We're working on adding Boise to that list. A couple of hour-and-a-half breakout sessions in Virginia Beach and Roanoke. If you're interested in any of those, just go to the homepage of Mr. Excel and click the upcoming seminars link. Plus, I'd love to come to your city. If you have an accounting group, the IMA, IIA, AICPA, I'd love to come out and do a seminar for your group or even a large company. If you have 30 to 50 people, get them together in a room. We'll come out and do a seminar for you. Let me show you this tip. Now, my favorite trick in Excel is when we need to copy a formula, we double-click the fill handle and Excel copies the formula all the way down. Unfortunately, that trick is relying on the column to the left. So let's say that we have a formula here. Maybe I want to join city, state, and zip into a single column. So I'll use equal E2, ampersand, quote, space, quote, ampersand F2, ampersand, quote, space, quote, ampersand G2. That'll join those three columns. Basically concatenate them. When I double click the fill handle, unfortunately, because the column to the left is only sparsely populated, it's where we put the apartment number or the suite number, it doesn't get copied down all the way. Well, I'm going to undo that. Here's a great trick that I learned. If you hide this column, format column hide, now Excel will rely on the column that is two columns to the left. Basically, it's looking at the visible column immediately to the left. So here we're in column D, double click the fill handle, it'll look over to column B. Of course, every customer has one line of their address filled in, so the data gets copied all the way down. Then we can use format column unhide to unhide the column. Now this works great whether you have data to the right or to the left. In this particular case, we did happen to have data that was to the right, so another solution would have been to insert a blank column between column C and D. Now when we double click the fill handle on E, since there's no data to the left, it will look to the right, and because the city happens to be filled in, it will also fill it in. So it's your call whether you want to hide column C or temporarily insert a new column D. Either way basically allows you to use that double click the fill handle much faster than dragging the fill handle and overshooting the end of the data, going back and forth and back and forth, what I call the fill handle dance. Hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.